feared dead and buried under mounds of concrete. A local family expected the worst after a devastating call from their loved one who worked for the UN in Haiti. But they've now learned he's safe. Fox News' Jeff Bernthal has more on the roller coaster of emotions his family went through.
It was like he sent his last message. Tell my wife I love her and I love the kids.
A heart-wrenching message from the man who married their daughter and is the father of two-year-old twins, a boy and a girl.
I'm thinking at that particular time that he will miss out on her proms and his son playing sports.
That's because Tarmo Joeveer, a UN peacekeeper, was buried under rubble, trapped for 40 hours, breathing through an air conditioning tube, using a radio or phone to communicate. His in-laws felt helpless in Crystal City, but not powerless.
We believed that God was going to deliver him. And every time we would hear that he was speaking, we knew God was in his corner.
This could have been very well my last day, and I was given a second chance, and that definitely has clarified a lot of things for me.
Joeveer appears to be the only survivor from the UN building that collapsed.
Just the floor fell off under my feet, and everything came crashing down. And next thing I know, I was laying on my side under the rubble.
And I'm just so blessed that he is out and safe and back at home with his wife and kids.
The Rock Community Fire Protection District showed us just how careful rescuers must be when responding to a disaster.
It's going to be a game of inches.
One wrong move could be deadly. In some cases, airbags are inflated to lift away tons of rubble. Joeveer's family says a rescue crew from Fairfax, Virginia, saved their son-in-law. Their heart goes out to the families who lost their loved ones. It's hard for them to celebrate. The Overstreets want to thank that rescue team that helped save their son-in-law's life. They say tonight he's resting with his family in Miami. Reporting from Jefferson County, Jeff Bernthal, Fox 2 News.